Hey Chase, what's going on? I thought you were going fishing.
Me too, John. I was getting ready to put in at the landing over at Lake Seminole for a tournament and launched the boat, hit the key, and nothing. So then I had to winch the whole boat back on the trailer. Now I got a back problem. So I'm just sitting here, you know, playing with my rod and reel. The only thing that does work.
I'll tell you what, I'll give you a hand, no worries. Why don't you jump down, we'll go ahead and check the voltage. I'll get some tools and we'll start there.
All right.
Now the first thing we want to do is we always want to check voltage. That's where everything starts. The batteries. Make sure the batteries are fully charged and ready to go. I'm going to set the meter up to DC voltage. The battery's located right down here, and I'm just going to go across the positive, and I'm going to go across the negative, and we're going to see what we have right here. Oh, your batteries are fully charged. We got way over 12 volts, so you're in good shape there.
Yeah, these batteries should be pretty good. They're fairly new, and I got that onboard charging system that keeps them pretty hot, so that shouldn't be an issue. I think we're going to have the issue towards the motor back here.
It probably is. Why don't you pull the engine cover? I have a cutaway battery here that we can show our viewers exactly how it works. Now, what a battery is, it's an electrochemical storage device. It's actually going to produce voltage. You can see the plates in here. These are positive and negative plates. And right here is a little separator that separates them all. Now, what happens is you put some sulfuric acid in there and water, which is electrolyte, makes a chemical reaction, and that's what zips our voltage and pressure, our amperage, to our starter motor. Now what we want to do is actually check it at the starter motor. We know we have good voltage at the battery. So if you come over here with me, you can see the starter motor is located right here. Got a positive wire coming in from the solenoid right here. And then what's happening, it's going to have a ground right here. It's going to turn the flywheel. So if I set our meter up right here, somewhere where you can see it, I can go ahead and go across this terminal. And we got Chase up there at the key. So if he just goes ahead and turns this thing over, we'll see what kind of voltage we have at the starter. Go ahead, Chase. Hold up. Oh man, you got a loose connection.
You mean I have to leave the tournament over a loose connection?
That's it. Well, at least you wasn't 25 miles offshore. You know, we got the Gulf of Mexico right here, and we got to go 25 miles to get to some deep water. That'd be a bad place to happen. Or worse yet, I was fishing off the Atlantic once in the Gulf Stream. Man, that thing goes from here all the way up to North Carolina. We're about 2 miles offshore. We were fishing for about an hour or 2 hours, just drifting. I mean, triple-tailed dolphin, we're following a log. Man, we crunked that boat up. Thank God it started. We come in due west. Man, we were 25 miles from any inlet. So that's why it's important to have that starter working right.
John, why don't you go ahead and tighten that up, and we'll just check the complete electrical system.
That's a good idea. All right, so you're not stuck 25 miles offshore with a no start condition. We're going to show you how to do some voltage drop, which is checking for resistance on a boat. That's so important due to the conditions it travels in. Now we can go here and we can start with a positive voltage drop. We're going to take it to the positive battery cable and come all the way over to the starter. I got my meter set up to volts right here, and I'm going to go all the way to the starter motor and then come to the battery over here. And Chase is up there. If you'll just turn it over for me. Great, almost a volt drop. That says we has a volt drop in the complete system. So now what we have to do is just simply isolate it. I can go across the solenoid right here, and we can check the contacts in the solenoid. Go ahead. It's not there. We're all right there. Now I can go from the solenoid over to the start wire right here, make sure that's not the culprit. Nope, that's showing 0.0. We don't have any voltage drop there. Don't forget about the ground side. We'll come right here on the ground over to the ground connection. It's not there. So where the voltage drop lies is from the solenoid all the way back to the battery. We got a cable issue, Chase.
Yes, I got some cables right here. We can show some resistance issues. Now here's a cable here. This is what you want. This is a perfect cable right here. There's nothing wrong with it, no resistance issues. But now here, we spliced it all apart for you so you could see. Now, our insulation, if it was run all the way across here, you wouldn't even see that issue. And you can get big resistance problems inside the wire. It could be electric running up the wire there, causing major issues. Also, let's look at this connection here. This is definitely what you don't want, because it's going to have high resistance issues, starting problems, electrical problems, a lot of problems.
Yeah, that's actually damaging the starter, too, because it's not getting the voltage it needs. Now, when you're dealing with a boat, you definitely want to use some kind of shrink wrap here, because you could be in salt water. Man, that stuff gets in this copper, it wicks up that wire, like you said. Shrink wrap connectors, your dielectric grease, anytime you're dealing with any kind of bolts, anti-seize, anything you can do to prevent that salt water intrusion on any of these wires, man, these cables like this, not gonna cut it on a boat. This is gonna cause the wire to wick up. Make sure you get some nice pressed cables so you don't have any issues, any exposed wires, and your starter will be like new.
John, we need to see about that wire there. I'd really like to go ahead and put a new starter on there so I don't have any issues on the water anymore.
Let's go ahead and show our viewers how we can do that next.
Now that we addressed the voltage drop issues, let's go ahead and show you, the viewer, how to replace a starter so you won't have any issues, so when you go fishing, your boat will be in tip-top shape. Chase, why don't you tell them a little bit about how to do this starter motor?
Well, the first thing, John, I need you to go ahead and disconnect the battery before we pull the big battery cable off here. And then what we got to do is we got a bolt here, two on the bottom, we got two on the top, and then we'll disconnect the power wire and the ground wire, and then we can pull our starter off and go ahead and replace it. We'll go ahead and grab some tools here.
All right,
get it undone?
I got the battery cable off, you're safe.
I'm going to pop that cover off the top.
Moving the top cover here just so you can see the shroud, it makes it a little bit easier to get to the starter motor itself. Here's the pinion and the contact. Well, your pinion's actually up there in there. It's a little bit too close. We'll address that with the new starter.
That can't be good.
Now, I'll go ahead and get this bolt. Give you a little hand here.
You got that new starter over there?
Oh, you got it off already.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a starter motor right here. Just match it up, make sure everything's good. We got our ground wire up here. We got our positive down there. Looks like a perfect match. Got a pinion up there. Everything's in good shape. You're gonna need that. I'll pull the ground wire off. Go ahead and start putting it back together.
All right.
We got it all hooked up. Now what we're looking for is we're looking for any kind of pinion contact. We want to make sure the pinion's going to contact the flywheel. Check that secure all your connections are all secure. Everything's out of the way. Everything looks good here. Looks like you got everything bolted up good. Let's give it a spin. All right, what we're looking for is pinion contact. And I'll give you a few tips, whether you're working on a car, boat motor, UTV, ATV. If the starter motor is making a high-pitched whine while you're cranking, that's because it's too far away from the flywheel. Now, if I'm cranking it over and I release the key and whing, it makes that whine, what's happening is it's too close, it's binding, and then when you release it, it pops out and flies. Now, this one's in good shape. We'll button it up and finish it. But we can give our viewers a few tips on maintaining a boat motor.
Yeah, you can talk about fuel here in just a second, but here's a couple tips for you. You know, there's a lower unit on this boat here. Now, and what we have in there is some fluid. There's lower unit fluid inside there. How that works is there's some fluid down there. During the winter months when you want to store your boat, you know, it's a real good idea to go ahead and change that fluid out because it's in water all the time. That's what a boat does. You go in the water. So you want to change out that fluid during the winter months because it actually could freeze inside there, gets moisture, and actually crack the lower unit. And also, you have a water pump down there. And we recommend you change it at least once a year because you're pumping water through it. And that's how this thing stays cooled, is pumping water from out in the lake into the engine.
That's right. Water cools that way. Now, you also want to check your fuel. Boats, you know, they're susceptible to getting water in the fuel. If you just fill up a vial like that, you can see the actual two-stroke oil right here, and then down here we got the water. You can check for any water in your fuel. Now also what you can do is you can run your boat every once in a while. You can take these ears right here and just put it over the intake ports, connect a garden hose to it, crank it up, run the water. That'll keep it running cool because, like Chase said, it runs off and cools off the water that's going into it. Run it every once in a while. Chase told you a little earlier, he had a trickle charger on this boat. He plugs it in and keeps it maintained. Take your batteries out, trickle charge them every once in a while, run the motor. All this preventative maintenance is going to make you have a great fishing trip next time out there. Now, if you want to watch some more of these videos, no problem. We got UTVs, ATVs, choppers, GSXR motorcycles, tractors, we got it all. So it's just a click away. You know, we're gonna put a starter and an alternator on a tractor.
An ATV.
And also a starter on a lawnmower. Thanks for watching.